Yo, this is Deontay, the Bronze Bummer Wilder, heavyweight champion of the world, and you're watching Real Fans Real Talk.
RealFansRealTalk.com. With Arthur Thomas, Trip Young, and intern Tom. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan, I get all my facts from my bro Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend the CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. RealFansRealTalk.com got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Is Jeremy Lin hurt?
We'll log onto the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives. Even tell a neighbor. Tell them Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter, tuning in should be the only thing on your agenda. Certified cosign, you know what I'm about, son. RealFansRealTalk.com. I'm out one. Real fans, real talk. Real fans, real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com. Real fans, real talk. Real fans, real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com.
All right, there you see it, ladies and gentlemen. Yet another award for Real Fans Real Talk, 4 years in a row with the Beta Award. This one once again for Best TV Series. That's why we weren't here last week. We were busy getting that hardware, and we had fresh off the charity event. We have Anthony Mason Jr. here to talk about a very successful NBA 2K tournament event. And before we get into all the details, let me introduce my co-host, the one and only Trip Young. What's going on, Trip?
What's going on? Yo, it's actually been a great week, like you said. And we had the charity event. Shout out to Bleachers and to Petro and Good Money by Ty, you know, and working with Family on Three, Anthony Mason Jr., a beautiful thing. Then we get the award on Thursday. And then on top of that, this weekend, the Ravens go out and they beat the Steelers, and the Giants go out and they beat the Eagles. So, I mean, I pretty much, you know, my week has just been excellent. You know, I can't even complain not one bit. But, Mace, what's going on? How was your week, man? I seen on Instagram. Yeah, Hustle Man.
That was great. Yeah.
Nineteen G's, Chief.
15, but yeah, nobody's counting.
I'm trying to go up. I'm trying to get, we trying to go all the way up, man.
You're a trip.
But we definitely gotta start off with this charity event, the 2K tournament. We did have a winner of the tournament. They did get the $500 cash prize. Myself, Statman, Mace, we all played in the tournament. Cliff played in the tournament.
I took an L on purpose because I wanted,
we know.
It wouldn't have been right for a person to host it.
Yeah, exactly. But in the first round, though?
Yeah, I took a dive.
Oh, okay.
The odds, it would have been like bad if I would have played my A game.
Yeah, because you know what? Because I didn't want to, the people at home to think with the charity and whatnot.
It's rigged.
Yeah, exactly. Like I can understand where you're coming from when you say that.
You can't rig 2K. You gotta either have the skills on the sticks or you don't. Like,
I don't know. You're actually New York. I don't know.
Listen, I can't call it. But you know what? The one thing that I can call is that it was all about Family on Three, and the charity event, and we really appreciate what you're doing with these kids. And the fact that you're working with these kids. And I want to shout out Vance and also Chrissy as well.
Yeah, Vance is at school right now.
Working with the kids and whatnot, because it's definitely a time where we need that, and we all need to be more involved with our youth and what's going on, and just teaching them something positive and giving them a different outlook on life. So we definitely appreciate you and what you're doing with Family on Three.
Thank you. Thanks for always supporting. Y'all come to all my events, whenever I ask y'all to come out, so... Definitely thank you for your support, and I agree.
That's one thing, we always say this and we mean it, whenever we got people doing positive things in our community, Real Fans, Real Talk are going to come out. We're going to support, we're going to show love, we're going to give you that coverage, and we're going to continue to do it. And that's why, we chose Family on Three, because we work with, we work with the Breast Cancer Awareness Foundation, we did the Lust Garden Foundation, GDA, which is Growth and Development Services. But, this year we wanted to do something with family where we could actually say, all right, well, yeah, you know, the money will be going here and here and here and whatnot. But family on three, that's family for us. You know what I mean? So we wanted to make sure that we brought the family together and we did something positive with Real Fans, Real Talk, and with Family on Three. You know, so and even with that, you know, we did our part over there. But personally, you know, I wanted to give a little bit more to the charity because I really respect what you are doing with these kids. So I brought you a little envelope here, Mace. That's for you, for the kids. Make it happen.
Trip.
You know, but we definitely have to do our
We don't have the giant size checks yet.
It's yeah. undisclosed number. We're not talking numbers. We're not talking
you
numbers.
Know. No, I mean the physical size, the giant ones that they hand out.
I got to make sure, because you know he'll trip. You I know, gotta make sure it's one
it's
in here.
It's gonna clear.
It's not just the envelope.
It's gonna clear.
Just wait till
good.
Next Tuesday, because when exactly. you see the way the thing is with the checking and the savings.
Yeah, it's real, man.
I was connected. Let them know it's definitely real. And we're gonna continue to support you, Mason, and whatever endeavors that you do, you just keep us posted. We're gonna come out. We're gonna support. Like I said, we're gonna give you that coverage, whatever it is. All you gotta do is let us know, and we all about supporting these kids, man. So we definitely gonna be there.
Thanks. Yo, these guys are great, man. I really support what y'all doing. Y'all stay with it and stay pushing forward with Real Fans, Real Talk. Y'all always out here with the community and trying to get back, you know. So definitely. I love what you guys are doing. I always continue to support what y'all do as well. Thanks for having me again, for sure.
Now you see he got his groove over there on the couch. We might have to just give you that couch, man. You
yeah, I really need a spot, man. I'm a real entertaining guy, you know what I'm saying?
Ladybug, stop.
Yeah,
see how Ladybug. It's all good.
Stuff.
It's all good, Ladybug. Don't worry. You know
Ladybug likes sitting next to me anyway, so.
See, I didn't say that. As long as she's sitting and not dancing on tables, everything is okay. All right.
Shout out to Lady Bug for doing a good job with the play-by-play.
Hosting.
Oh
my God. You got to keep her out the race, though. Like.
Shout out to DJ Triple Play on the ones and twos.
Facts. The music was good. The host was doing the host, Ladybug.
The whole night, the bartender was on the racetrack.
Like, if we was racing, Ladybug was on the racetrack.
Ladybug was everywhere. I will say that, you know, you got to love it, man. She definitely holds us down. And, you know, she's the person that needs to be on the mic at these events.
For sure.
She'll keep everybody excited. She bounces around all over the place. And, you know, but just a positive experience. Shout out to H2O as well for coming out and supporting.
H2O.
You know, he did play in the tournament. He didn't win the tournament. I ain't going to say, you know, how things went, but shout out to H2O.
Man,
we definitely appreciate that.
He can ball in
that.
Real life. So.
Yeah, he can ball in real life. So it doesn't always translate.
Shout out H2O for taking all charity games super serious.
He does.
H2O be going to charity game for 40, too.
He definitely like. Does. So shout out to H2O. And also, as well, shout out to Imagine, like you said, Mace.
Yeah, shout out
she helped us get everything organized. So we definitely appreciate you. And she's going to be working with us on some stuff in the future as well. So big shout out to Imagine.
Shout out to Statman. Yo, Statman can play. Look how he sit back. Like, you finna say something since you want to congratulate
me.
I'll take it.
I also got my debut as a bouncer for the first time, keeping the peace.
Hey, yeah.
I'm used to being Ladybug's security guard, but
so you might
now
have been security
I get to be
for
a
everybody.
Bouncer too. So you know, I got that on my resume now.
For sure.
In case I need another job.
You my ringer though. If I go to a 2K, not no big tournament, I don't know how good, but I take you to the hood though. I definitely take you to the hood.
That's what it means more anyway, Stat.
I'm telling you, that's who won the game at the bar.
Yeah, that is
they
that is true.
They start shouting Brooklyn, here's BK.
He came out of the winner came out of
we
the
do
woodworks.
This daily.
He wasn't even in the tournament originally. He just happened to be walking past and seeing what was going on and wanted to be a part of the tournament. And he came in and he wound up winning the whole tournament, you know, so.
He said he did it for Brooklyn, but everybody was pretty much from
yeah,
Brooklyn.
Yeah, I think, yeah. I think
nah,
so.
It was a
well,
different...
no, it was a couple of people from the Bronx, though.
It was another Brooklyn.
We had
hit.
Somebody travel all the way from Long Island
yep.
to come.
Take an L.
Yeah, he definitely did. But you know what? It's for a good cause. So.
And it's fun, too. You know, everything that Real Fans Real Talk puts on, whether it's bowling or now we have the 2K tournament, it's fun and you raise money for charity, so you can't lose in that situation. You have a good time, win or loss with the tournament or whatever the case may be. You have fun and you know, it's for a good cause. So speaking of our future, though, Peter from Brooklyn writes, are you guys going to do a Madden tournament? And it's something that's in the works. We're thinking probably sometime, maybe the week before the Super Bowl, we might do something along those lines and have a Madden tournament. That's, I think that'll be fitting.
Well, we know it's not 2K, so I hope it is Madden.
No, I don't play no games.
Everyone at the 2K tournament wants a sequel, and, you know, it is the first annual one. Maybe we'll do it around playoff time with the NBA.
Yeah, we got to bring that 2K back.
Yeah, we bring it back because I know a lot of people was, you know, they was upset they didn't win. We had one guy, he came in late, he lost, then bought back in, lost again, and then bet on somebody else and then lost again. So I you know, I felt bad, but, you know, at the same time, if you just want to spend your money, then, you know, just spend your money. Hey, it is what it is. I can't stop you from doing that. But, you know, everybody that was there, you know, had a good time. They really enjoyed themselves. You know, it was a fun night, and it's 2K. You can't go wrong with 2K, man. You know, so we definitely gonna do another one, you know, soon, because the people have been asking us about it, and I'm gonna give Mace a chance to redeem himself because, you know, he went down.
I'm cold, man. I don't play games. I'm a real life type individual. You feel me?
Speaking of real life, your former team, the Miami Heat, Dwayne Wade is coming back to town tonight.
Tonight, right?
Yeah. As a Chicago Bull. What do you think is going to be the fan interaction? Sometimes you see people coming back and they get booed.
No, it couldn't. That's Wade County. Yeah. Like, he made Miami, so it should be nothing but love. I would think, probably a standing ovation. You know, especially he went out classy.
It wasn't his fault. It's not like he wanted to leave. I mean, Pat Riley didn't want to pay him the money. And if anything, insulted him, so.
Yeah, and then I'm saying, like, he chose to go home, you know, to Chicago.
Yeah.
So you got to respect that, especially in the last years. He gave the best years of his career, for sure.
And it was $6 million more. I mean, he took all the sacrifices when LeBron was there.
Yep.
It's not like they were a legit contender unless Bosch was able to come back, which, you know, that was uncertain. So you're asking him to take less money, and... You know, obviously Pat Riley was looking for the future, but you said Wade County. Now, interesting comparison. Who is bigger for the city of Miami in sports history, Dwayne Wade or Dan Marino?
How many chips Marino get?
Zero. That's why I'm thinking Dwayne Wade. But I mean, a lot of football is.
Think because of no knock to I'm gonna call you back. Nah. No knock to Dan, and shout out Dan because he's in one of my favorite movies ever, Ace Ventura, Pet Detective.
So Laces Out.
Laces Out. What was his name? I forgot his name.
Ray Finkel.
Yeah, so I would say no knock to Dan, but just from my generation, you got to think about the times. Like, you're going to give it to D-Wade. Dwayne Wade, you brought a chip. You brought a – and then Florida was – You know, I mean, Miami Dolphins was Miami Dolphins before Dan, whereas Miami Heat was nothing before D-Wade, you know.
And he got three of them.
Three championships. And he's the all-time career points leader for them, assists leader, steals leader, minutes leader, games leader, like pretty much every stat you could think of with Miami Heat.
Yeah, he owns South Beach. Yeah, he owns that.
And you know what? They didn't even really give LeBron, you know, a hard time like that when LeBron came back after he left. So they're definitely not going to give Wade a hard time. Like, you got to think about all the work that he put in for Miami.
Yeah, that's a different feeling.
Yes, you got to show respect. And like you said, Stat Man, he didn't want to leave. It was a money situation, which he definitely deserved. Because he did take pay cuts, you know, for LeBron and Bosh to come over. He's right. He's still balling this year. He might even be better this year than he was in the past couple of years. He got a 3-pointer now. I ain't never seen Wade shooting threes like the way he's been shooting this season. Wade. You know, so you definitely gotta love that.
That's why we're tripping off the jump shot.
I said last thing to go is the jump shot, and Chicago's looking good. I mean.
Yeah.
You're looking at their own big three there with Rondo, Wade, and Butler sitting at 4-4 right now.
That's what they were saying. They were better off with D-Rose, without D-Rose. And I'm like, yeah, if you replace them with D-Wade and
Rondo, of course.
Of course you're better off for sure. But, yeah, I like their team. I like Chicago. I like who was just playing the other night? The Timberwolves, too.
Yeah,
well, the Timberwolves are a good young team.
I just like my man Carl Anthony.
Yeah, Towns has been
crazy what his potential might be.
In 2K, for some reason, I'm drafted to the Timberwolves. I don't know why, but, you know.
They need a point guard, you know?
Well, I actually created a center that did something different this time. And now that didn't make sense. I created a center because the Knicks have Noah, and I think that's, like, out of their starting five, maybe, you know, the shooting guard position. But I tried something different this time and went with the big man. So, but
the Knicks won last night.
They did win last night.
In the Battle of the Boroughs, holding it down. The Brooklyn Nets came into the Garden, and it was looking a little, scary there for the first half, but Carmelo Anthony definitely did his thing, and it was one of those moments where I'm like, why are you taking that shot? Oh, it went in, okay. You know, and he kept doing it. He was just on fire in the third quarter. Porzingis did well, and the Knicks.
Hernan Gomez as well. Yeah. He had a really good game off the bench. 14 points. No, Jennings did well as well with 11 assists he had.
Led the team, boy.
Yeah, he did. He definitely
I like Jennings,
did.
Man.
That
like
that was a great pickup for the Knicks, you know, to have him coming off the bench and then you got D. Rose starting. Like, that's a great 1-2 punch at that point guard spot. So, listen.
I was scared. I didn't even know. I looked at the game and D. Rose didn't come back in.
Yeah, anytime he don't come back,
I was like, you always had me Googling all types of shit.
Like, wait a minute, what's going on? Now, just that Brandon Jennings was just hot.
Dude. Yeah, that's what they said. Yeah,
he had a team involved. And you know what? In that situation, it's like, you know, you want to preserve D-Wade. If you don't need a Rose, if you don't need him, you know.
Take out somebody that's hot. Like,
yeah.
The first game against the Nets, with the Brooklyn Nets, they were down by, I forgot who they were playing, the first game of the season. They were down by like 10 points or something late in the fourth quarter, and they gave up guys out there, and that bench just brought it to almost a tie game. And, like, you know, the coach has a decision. Like, it gets under a minute, but he left those guys out. When you're hot, you're hot. You don't want to ruin somebody who's hot. And Jennings is somebody that could start on half the teams in the NBA in the point guard position.
Yeah.
So
when he's healthy, yeah, definitely.
And that's one of the worst things as a player. Like, when you're in there, if you're a part of that second or that first unit or whatever units that's following, and you hot, and if you're a part of that second unit and the coach is going to throw the first unit in just because y'all got a lead, oh, man.
Yeah, that's crazy. It ruins the whole, rotation. Now, the whole flow, excuse me. Now, the Lakers are 4-4.
I like this.
They beat the Warriors, too. Are the Lakers going to be a playoff team? What do you think?
I like the point guard. Russ is nice, man. He's very poised.
Once he stops snitching.
Very smart.
Then he'll be better.
I mean, well, that ain't got nothing to do with the game. As long as snitching ain't a part of basketball inside that box, he good. Like, outside the court, it don't even matter, but as far as the game, but yeah, you ain't gotta be friends outside the court. Y'all just gotta mesh on the court.
As long as you play well.
Yeah, it's tough. You want to say yeah because they beat the Warriors, but at the same time, you know, the West is strong. Come on, you got San Antonio. Yeah, I just was watching that game last night. Was crazy.
I think they need a seasoned veteran on that Lakers team.
Big too.
Yeah,
and I think somebody need to work with Randle.
Because he's having a good year.
He got, like, all the tools, but I just, like...
Yeah.
Has he made a world peace on the team just as a... Or did they drop him again?
You know what? I don't know what he's doing right now.
He's not exactly the proper leader.
Yeah. I think he's just, like, when he come back to L.A., they just like, yo, world.
Yeah.
You want?
Yeah, just come on.
They just have him out there to beast on people.
Yeah.
And, you know, they keep that veteran thing. That's what I like about the NBA. They keep the vets around for the young players.
Which is a good thing because they're a really young team with Ingram and Randall, all of these guys. Russell, they're all
Ingram got to turn up. Like, just go, young boy. You just got to go. You got the green light, and then they got that's another thing. That's a plus. They got a good coach in Luke.
Yeah,
you know, Luke is a player's coach.
That's a whole, you know,
very relatable to those young guys. Y'all growing together. This is his first year.
Exactly.
Taken out of the Warriors.
You beat the Warriors by 20. First of all, and you know what? Shout out to Larry Nance Jr.
He was the former Warriors coach last year, so he knows a lot about the team.
But you don't know that the Lakers are just going to blow that team out by 20 points.
Yeah.
And Larry Nance Jr. is going to dunk on David West and give him a gill on the way up to the basket.
That was crazy.
Shout out to him for that. You know, because I love when you play 2K And sometimes, you know, you have your franchise and you put these guys on your team. People don't know. They be like, nah, this kid ain't that good. But then when you start to actually see them get minutes and they start playing, you know, and they do well. So that's a good thing, seeing him throw it down like that and seeing them beat up on the Warriors. It's good for a young team like that.
So you're not a Warriors fan?
I'm not a Warriors. I mean, you know, I'm LeBron James 100% all the way, as you can see by the Cavs hat that I'm wearing, and they won the championship, you know, this year, you know, for Cleveland, you know, came back from three games,
on this show.
Down 3-1, and we did, you know, we did talk about that. We did say that was going to happen, and I spoke about, you know, Iman Shumpert and the bun, and if he hooked it up, if he didn't have, you, what you call it, the Temptation 5 Heartbeats here, dude, you said it was?
The Samurai cut.
The Samurai, okay, if he didn't have the Samurai, but he put it in the bun, and it was good. When he put it in the bun, they won. So we spoke about that.
You're still bringing this up.
You know, I'm just saying, they won, you know. And they didn't, you know. And then they started off the season beating up on the Knicks, which, you know, I got to.
All right, so change the subject. We were talking about the Warriors before. I'm not sure if we asked you what's your opinion on the whole Kevin Durant situation leaving OKC.
He had a choice. You know what I'm saying? You gotta live or die with that choice. I mean, I can't knock him for that because inside, as a player, you don't know. And like when he moved, he seemed happier. So you got to make what's happy for your career, you know what I'm saying? He didn't have the same smile last year with OKC or in, like, these last few years. So, yeah. You know what I'm saying? You can't knock it. But at the same time, like, a lot of people knock the situation, like, go to the Warriors, going to a team to just beat you in the finals and shit like that. I mean, things like that. But, but things like that. So, I don't know. You can label it as a soft move because of the situation, but at the same time, like, he'll play, like, you get to, in this day and age, you can't.
As a professional ball player, would you leave a team and go to a team that just finished beating you the way Golden State beat OKC?
Nah, I can't say. It just depends. Like, if the history was there, it's not a history of them beating them in the finals every year. That was the first year they beat them. Mm-hmm. You feel what I'm saying? So, yeah, but as a player, I feel like the other big players, like, I'm not finna leave my squad.
Yeah.
Even though, unless I got a squabble, unless it's like me and my man don't see eye to eye on some Shaq and Kobe,
yeah.
Shaq and whatever and situation.
Shaq could be part of it.
You know what I'm saying?
Westbrook.
We don't see eye to eye. So, yeah, I'm out. But, yeah, I don't know if I would defer to going to the team that I just, yeah, I can't say
I think
that
you
I
go
would.
To the team where you have the best chance to win. And that's where he felt he had the best chance to win. Yeah, they lost to them, too. But, I mean, what difference does that make? The old saying is can't beat them, join them. So, I mean.
And understood, like, I agree with that. Like, if you really look at the map,
I mean,
where else were you going?
Yeah. What other team could afford you and give you the chance
to win? He could have went to the Spurs.
I mean, there was the Spurs.
But there wasn't a look. That's not the look of a KD.
Yeah, I guess I could. Yeah,
like, the way he fits in with the Warriors is exactly what they do.
Yeah.
Pulling threes and they playing free. Like, you know.
Is there any other team that you could have seen him going to outside of Golden State?
Only other team I would, like, I swear, I put this on everything. I was talking to my man before he even did it. I like, yo, bro, if he leaves OKC, he's either going to the Warriors or he's going to pull, like, I'm going home move to the Wizards. Yeah. Like, other than that, you know what I'm saying, Knicks is scary because Melo was here. A lot of people,
you know. And they pretty much play the same position.
Yeah, you feel what I'm saying? So, and everybody else on the East Coast was like, who? What, Miami, I'm going to start from scratch. Orlando, I'm starting from scratch.
Yeah.
There was nowhere else, you know what I'm saying, to go other than that. You're not going to the Rockets with Harden.
And it's not like he was leaving home. So, I mean, LeBron was criticized, but for some reason, I feel like some people are criticizing KD
who are
LeBron fans.
It's
like, and it's like, it was okay when he did it to leave home and go to Miami to go for a big three, which everyone thought they would to hand them the championship. Obviously, they didn't win it the first year because it took some time to build that chemistry. But since we're on the subject, do they win it this year? They are the favorite.
The Warriors?
Yeah. Or do you think they need another year for chemistry purposes?
I don't know, man. I don't really like that they don't have, like, a dominating big like that. Like, if they, even though the scoring is, you know, tremendous and everything is, you know, they might gel. I feel like because they're such good players and they play, like, a similar type of basketball.
Yeah.
The Jill will probably.
Bulls dynasty's never had a dominating big, but
They also had Jordan. Nobody.
I wouldn't even say a dominating big. I guess Shula is cool.
That rim protector like Bogut.
Something. Yeah. If Bogut was there, the I would be like, yo.
Well, yeah, that would be different because they gave up the
I don't know how they gave up Bogut.
Bogut, Spates, Azili, you know, Barbosa. They gave up a lot of defense. Now, if you look at actually this season, which is, you know, one thing I said was, which is, you know, they're going to suffer with is the defense. They're still... they're still first in the league in scoring this year. Actually, them and Miami are both tied. Last time I checked, it was like 110 points a game, but they're giving up a lot of points, though. That's the thing. So it reminds me of those Phoenix Suns, Steve Nash teams with Amari when there was a lot of offense and the defense wasn't there, and or the Dallas teams with Dirk and those guys before they got Tyson Chandler, where it's a lot of offense, but there's no defense really. I mean, you got Draymond Green, but outside of that, Draymond Green is not doing what Bogut did last year in the paint. And I think, you know, a lot of people want to say that, you know, Draymond Green not being there last year really caused them to lose, but they lost a lot when Andrew Bogut got hurt. Because when he couldn't come back, it was kind of like open season, and the Cavs just pretty much did what they wanted, you know, in the paint.
Yeah, I agree with. I wouldn't even say a dominate. They just need a force down there. But I think they're doing well.
Patchouli is no Andrew Bogut.
No way. Chip is kind of cold, man. Cavaliers playing good basketball.
Yeah, they did take their first loss though the other night to the Hawks, but they are looking really good. You know, Kyrie is looking amazing. I mean, LeBron's going to be LeBron, you know, Kevin Love, but, you know, everybody else is
lost
really,
the game,
really gelling.
I'm sorry, Kevin Love playing soft as it's tissue the other night.
When they lost.
Well, I mean, can't even say soft, but he just wasn't, like, they needed him that game. Like, they needed that little rebound, and they needed a finish at the bottom. He was missing, not getting that and one. They needed that because they could have got him over the hump, but that was a good game.
Well, they did get to celebrate at the White House, giving Obama a number 16 jersey.
Number 16. That's
A number 16. I don't know what the reference with the 16, but I like how Obama said that, you know, beating the Warriors solidified the Bulls as the best team of all time, the 96 Bulls, because that's 73-9 that took away the 72-10. If they closed the deal, then you have the debate.
Yeah,
which
honestly,
team was
that record doesn't matter if you don't win a championship to follow that. That's all right. You beat them, but they won a championship. So
nah, that record matters.
You know, on the bigger scheme of things, they didn't win a chip though. Like
you won 73-2,
but you couldn't win 16 more. You won 73 in the regular season, but you couldn't win 16 in the playoffs to seal the deal.
Playoffs is different. That's
we're talking about
year.
With the best team in basketball.
I mean, they showed you that. That's why they was in the finals.
You know, they only played the Cavs two times out of those 82 games in the regular season. So
that's true. Well, I mean, you know, I'm not complaining because, again, you know, with those Cavs, you know, winning the championship this year. I'm from right here, Brooklyn. That's why I always support my Nets as well. And we
were,
as a matter of fact,
lost yesterday, so that's why you want to go on.
They did lose.
Oh, that's why you switched hats.
They didn't have Jeremy Lin yesterday. They didn't have Jeremy Lin, and Brook Lopez was on restricted minutes. So I'm not holding
them. So how you become a Cavaliers fan?
I'm a LeBron fan.
Okay.
You know, plus, you know.
Understood. I'm a player guy.
You know,
I don't have too many teams.
The Knicks are 3-4. The Nets are 3-5. It's not that much of a difference. It's still early in the season. I mean, the Nets, you know, they put up a fight a lot of times. I've been watching the Nets too, and they're not looking as bad as they did last year. But somebody,
I mean, we went to the game the other night. They played the Pistons, and they dominated the Pistons. I don't. Another guy, Brook Lopez. I don't know where he came up with a 3-point shot either.
I didn't know Hollis was that good. Hollis.
Yeah, he is. He is pretty. Whitehead actually played really well as you know the other night.
What's
when
the young
the
boy
Pistons
name?
Well.
My boy.
You know, so they. I mean, they
young
in the
boy from Syracuse.
From that plays on the Nets right now. I'm not sure, but whoever it was, he's from Brooklyn, so we're gonna support him because that's the home team. So we definitely gotta support him. But we do got a lot more to get to, and we do have the recap video from Ballin' for Peace. I mean, excuse me, from the 2K tournament that we're gonna play with everybody featured on that. And then we got a music video we're gonna play a little bit later. D Chambers, shout out to Coney Island. He got a new video, Just Brooklyn. We're gonna play that. And Math is on the way. He just texted me. Y'all know the rappers come late. You know that. Yeah, so don't sweat it. He's definitely gonna be in the building. He just texted me. He said he's almost here. So we're gonna get that, you know, in a second. But NFL, It's a lot going on in football right now. I mentioned early in the program that the Giants did beat the Eagles in a very good game.
Did our director Cliff hear that? The Giants beat the Eagles this past Sunday?
Excuse me, Cliff. Cliff, can you hear me on the back there in the booth?
Eagles fan director, did you
hear that?
Did you copy that?
All right, just wanted to make sure. I didn't want to put that out there, Cliff, like that. But since the world, you know, saw it, I didn't want to say it. I didn't want to hurt your feelings because we got love for you, bro. You know, but the Eagles, they suck, and they haven't won a Super Bowl yet, and probably not going to. You know, you talked all that mess about Carson Wentz, and Giants defense shut him down.
Now, will it take longer for the Eagles to win a Super Bowl as much as it did the Cubs to win the World Series? Is it going to be
over
108 years?
Longer because it's the Eagles.
Over on the so you're taking but the over. I agree with
they
you.
They got Chunky Campbell's Chunky Soup. You did mention that, mm-hmm. right? You know, outside of that, I can't really say too much else about the Eagles. But like I said, Cliff, you still a real MVP. You know, but as far as the Eagles go, I cannot say anything positive about those guys because. I mean, it's the Eagles, and who would I be to, you know, say something positive when they just finished getting spanked by these guys here, those the New York Football Giants? I know it was a heartbreaker, Cliff, because I know you wanted to come in here this Thursday and tell us, you know, that the Eagles won and say all of this stuff, but you're not able to do that, and I understand where you're coming from, but you don't, you know, at least you got the Beta Award because you can still understand what greatness feels like. You know, and that's what I really wanted for you to feel and to get that feeling because it's different when your team actually wins championships, you know?
And shout out to the Cubs. I know we haven't been live in a couple of weeks. The actual Cubs fans that, you know, which not the ones who are bandwagon jumpers or whatever. But anyway, we are on the subject of football. Tom Brady is winning, and I have this debate a lot with people. People are saying that Tom Brady should be an MVP candidate. I personally disagree with that because he didn't play 25% of the season. So, I mean, they were 3-1 without him, and it was their third string that got the loss. So I just don't agree with it. What's your take, Tripp?
I think that if he finishes the season with better numbers than everybody else after missing four games, then yeah, he definitely deserves the MVP. And right now, he's looking better than a lot of quarterbacks. And, you know, like I said, if he has those numbers, and he's with no interceptions right now, and he has more passing yards, more touchdowns, if he finishes the season better than everybody else, then yeah, give him the MVP.
Jimmy Garoppolo in his two games, he didn't have Rob Gronkowski.
Nobody has Aaron Hernandez. The prison system has Aaron Hernandez.
You Bubba, didn't need to finish that. I was just thinking about the tight Aaron ends. Hernandez. I was thinking about Bennett. Right, I was thinking about the history of the use of the tight ends with
that's
the
Bubba
Patriots.
That got Aaron Hernandez right now. You think
But he didn't have Rob Gronkowski. He still won the two games. And if he didn't get injured, they'd probably still be undefeated with Garoppolo with all the weapons that they have.
Listen, it's definitely possible, but I mean, we're talking about numbers here. Like, if he comes with missing four games and finishes the season with better numbers than every
but
other quarterback,
better total numbers, I don't think is possible. If he goes on pace, he'll probably get 4,000 yards, and Matty Ice could probably get close to or past 5,000.
But where are they going to finish at?
But
that's the thing.
Per game, you know, is a different story. Per game, maybe Brady, you know, finishes higher. But at the same time, let me ask you this, using a basketball analogy. You know, I've heard the analogy of them playing 60 games in a season. Do you give the MVP award to somebody that played 60 games instead of 82 games, which is similar, approximately 25% of the season missing? Can you still give that to them?
It depends on where they are at the end of the season. Like, if a team, you know, winds up finishes first place in the conference – And the numbers are crazy, then I would still give it to him.
And you're talking about numbers as in points per game? And
I'm talking about
game?
Everything. Points, rebounds, win share, PER.
No, I'm saying, like, you know, per game, because obviously the total numbers aren't going to be as high.
Yeah, you know, I mean, if we're talking about...
And I'm not hating on Tom Brady, let's take it from a perspective using your Cavaliers. Let's say Kyrie Irving plays 40 minutes, gets 40 points, and has a triple-double, 10 rebounds, 10 assists, which is not... you know, very likely, and LeBron James plays 30 minutes, gets 32 points, 8 rebounds and 8 assists. Now, he played less minutes, but his PER is higher, and he's LeBron James. He's the big name, similar to the way Tom Brady is. Do you give the MVP to the guy who played the whole game in Kyrie Irving and got the triple-double, or to somebody that would have gotten the triple-double if he played 40 minutes?
Well, here's the thing. Like, even because, I mean, people talk about in the finals, but like, some people thought that Kyrie should have got the finals MVP. But, I mean, LeBron led every statistical category, so I still got to give it to LeBron. If we're talking about, because that's what LeBron would do, he's going to lead
the
in
finals. But.
Yeah, but even, you know, if we're talking about a game-to-game basis, I still give LeBron that play of the game because, I mean, if you're playing less time, but you're still putting in more points, rebounds, assists.
Not more points. He put in 32 versus 40.
And how many assists, how many rebounds, how many steals?
8 rebounds, 8 assists.
And
so
what did Kyrie do outside
per minute,
of the points?
His player efficiency rating, if you're paying attention, 40 for Kyrie, 10 and 10. And LeBron is 32, 8 and 8 in 30 minutes versus 40 minutes. Well, so per minute, he has more production. But overall for the game, Kyrie Irving got the triple-double with 40 points. But if LeBron would have played 40 minutes instead of 30, which is 25% less, similar to Tom Brady's 25% less for the season.
Well, in that situation, no. His numbers is high, so yeah, I'm going to go with Kyrie.
Yeah, and there's no chance that Tom Brady's numbers are going to be higher in less games. He missed 4 games. He's not he could throw for 4,000 yards. He's on pace for 4,000 yards, so which is the equivalent of 5,000 yards if you played the entire season. But that's the best he could do. You're going to have Stafford and Matty Ice and everybody closer to 5,000 because they play the whole season.
Like, where does it come from, stats to play in? What's the even middle ground like?
Well,
when you talk
aside
about
from
MVP
it,
status?
You have the most valuable player. They did not go with 1-3 or 0-4, and then he comes in and he's the savior. They were winning without him. They really didn't need him. They'd probably be undefeated if Jimmy Garoppolo didn't get hurt.
I mean, that's possible, but we can't say it unless we actually seen it played out. We got to wait till the end of the season because we don't know where the Falcons are going to end up.
You're saying
if
the Patriots will be better.
Tom Brady out for the entire season, at worst, if they had Garoppolo, they'd be probably a 14-2 team without Tom Brady.
Nah, I don't know about that. When Tom Brady was out for the season and Matt Castle came in, they was 10-6. I don't know about 14-2.
Well, that's a different year, different team, supporting cast. Offensive line,
like,
different
everything. But we talk about 14-2.
So they went
into zero interceptions.
Healthy, most healthy teams are not going 14-2.
Garoppolo had zero interceptions, too,
because
he has all
day to grow. So you play it full out, no Brady. They still going to the chip the way they playing? No Brady.
To the chip, probably not, but the season, yeah.
Nah, but not 14-2. I cannot see them going 14-2 without
crazy.
That's yeah. 14-2.
That's a stacked team.
So clearly you don't like Tom Brady.
Even if you just go 3-1,
clearly he's not a Brady fan,
right?
He's not, but
we can't. 12-4.
But we cannot. But 14-2, come on, man. That team.
But 12-4, you can believe.
Going 14-2. Like I just can't see that team without Tom Brady.
They lost one with their third string.
I didn't see it.
Yeah, but that's we're talking about the first 4 games of the season. We're not talking about going through an entire season, and that's 4 games with the motivation, knowing
that
Tom Brady is out, but he's gonna come.
How many
he's
games
gonna
in
come
the season?
Back.
16.
So 16. Yeah, but we're talking. All right. The knowledge that okay,
so
Tom Brady
like
is gonna.
Four or five games
Tom Brady is gonna come back.
Statistics.
So and you know
they're losing 4 or 5 games if you're talking stats.
If you go 3-1 and multiply that by 4, they lose 4, so they go 12-4.
Yeah, but it doesn't work. It doesn't just work that way.
I
just because you went
3-1,
they like
lost
to work
with
it.
Their third.
Nah, just because you, just because you,
Ronkowski was out
because
the first
you play,
2 games.
Because you're not playing those same 4 teams every week after that for
exactly.
The next for the next
injuries,
12 games.
Players.
So to say that team is going to go 14-2 that without Brady, that's a lot. We're talking about them knowing that Brady is coming back. And, yeah, they're going to play. They're playing harder just because they're pissed off that Brady got suspended in the first place. But now you're talking about, you know, getting deeper into the season. Like
yeah,
you said,
I just feel like
it's a fine
as far
line
as them
before,
maybe panicking
stats.
If Brady is out, the players are probably
it's
not
a fine
motivated.
Line.
Yeah, it's a little,
it's a fine line point. Between stats and somebody's play and their individual's play. Like, people would like to get stats and be like, if
it's
not the stats,
all about
it?
Stats.
That's
even
what you said, gave
us
number
man,
calculation.
But I mean,
you gave me number calculations just now about why this team would be better without Brady.
Well, I didn't say they'd be better without Brady.
Basically,
but
you
said
they'd
be
just as good. That's just as good.
Yeah, that's a problem. They'll be
Patriots. They'll lose another game the rest of the year.
14-2 is still being the Patriots without Brady.
Hold up. If Tom Brady did not play this season, they would go 14-2.
Between 12-4 and 14-2, somewhere in that range.
And you're basing it off because you're the stat
just,
man.
That's just crazy.
And it's statistics.
That is just crazy.
No,
that
I'm
they
basing
would go,
it on the surrounding cast, their defense, their offensive line,
yeah, but
their
we're
running
talking about,
game, their passing options.
Who they play in the first four games of the season?
Well, the one they lost was the Bills,
which is a team that knows them. And a lot of times, what happens with these quarterbacks that you never saw on the field before, it takes a little while. But once you start getting that footage on them, then things start to get a little bit different. Yeah, once they start to see Garoppolo more, you know, things are going to change. Like 14-2 is that's crazy. The Jeremy Lin effect. There you go. Lin Sanity. We had Lin Sanity. But once you start to figure that out, things change a little bit. And then on top of that, I think
the best point out of this situation is the one you made as far as the team still being motivated, knowing that Brady's coming back. So that factor has something to do with it. Everything else I don't agree with. But your Ravens are playing tonight on Thursday Night Football against the Browns, division rivalry. I mean, you could pretty much, you know.
So you're not a New York fan at all?
No, I like.
I mean, he likes the Giants and the Ravens.
I just like.
No,
you know what?
I can't make sense of his stuff.
Listen,
I know the reason for
trip, huh?
Because he played with the Ravens with Madden way back.
Where are you from? Where are you from again?
I'm from right here. I'm from five blocks up.
Oh, all
right. Five blocks up, Cumberland Street. What's up?
Okay, I got you.
They know me out here.
I'm just checking. Right? Oh no,
they just
Ray
don't know why.
Ray Lewis is my favorite player.
Listen, team hats on.
I'm a Yankees fan through and through. There's no other team for me but the Yankees. But I like the Ravens and I like the Giants in football. And you know basketball,
Nets,
I support
the
Nets because that's Brooklyn. So Brooklyn gonna support Brooklyn all the time. You know,
except for when you're from
Cavaliers.
Brooklyn,
as,
you grew up
as
a Knicks
D. Chambers would say,
fan.
It's just
are you
Brooklyn.
A Cavaliers fan?
I'm a LeBron fan. I support the Cavs because he plays for the Cavs. When he went to Miami, I rooted for Miami.
And before that, you were a Sixers fan with
I wasn't a Sixers fan. I was an AI fan. It's a difference.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh, I'm just saying.
I was just a fan of AI.
I guess you got to be that when you're a sports analyst and
like
stuff,
that,
right?
You know?
You got to be able to jump around. So.
Listen, I support not my really. I support my.
just in case somebody
most
comes
of the
in.
Guys
I support
on,
my New York
teams.
I support the Giants. That's his strategy.
The Giants, the
just
Yankees,
in case they
and
come
the Nets. Those are my New York teams. You know? But, you know, listen, the Giants did get that win. The Ravens did get that win. So, like I said,
OBJ always get caught in compromising positions.
Exactly. But you know what? Because it's getting late in the hour, we're going to play that recap video for you guys from the first annual Real Fans Real Talk 2K tournament. And we come back. Ladybug will be joining us on the set.
I look good. Okay.
Nope. You can relax. She is in the building.
Exactly. So,
yeah, Ladybug, come out here sitting
long
next
hair,
to me.
Long hair, don't care. You know, Ladybug is back there. She getting cute for y'all. You know, so y'all
short hair, long hair, short hair, short.
But we're gonna run that recap video for y'all, and like I said, when we come back, Ladybug will be with us. But make sure y'all following us on the social media at Real Fan Talk on Instagram and Twitter, facebook.com/RealFansRealTalk, and subscribe to that YouTube channel, youtube.com/ForTheFansProductions, RealFansRealTalk.com. And make sure that y'all going online and y'all supporting Family on 3 and everything that they got going. Y'all got to be in the loop for what they're doing next. So be on point with that. At Family on 3, y'all make sure y'all follow them on Instagram so y'all can know what's going down.
All right, without further ado, the video.
To explain, I'm black beetle cream seats in the Regal rocking John. blended lenses, like to see them spread. Eagle took a club and let a party on the table, screaming, everybody's famous. Like clockwork, I blow it all. Then get some more. Get you somebody that can do both. Like Beatles got the bass belly rolling. She thinks she love me, I think she trolling. That girl is a real crowd, please. Small world, all her friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. Haters mad for whatever reason. Smoke in the air, binge drinking. They lose it when the DJ drops the knee.
Came in with two girls look like shoes in their real clothes. A broke can only point me to a rich hoe. A yellow bitch with green hair, a real weirdo. Black man, yellow lamb, red like dope. They say they cool on them, just came in through the side though. It's so much money on the floor, we buying school clothes. Why you bring a money machine to the club for? And a pint of lean, pound of weed and a kilo. You're a stealth pest, I hate her like a rondo. I upgrade your baby mama to a condo. Like Chapo serving Yayo to the gringos. Black Beetle club clothes when I say so.
That girl is a real crowd, please. Small world, all her friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. For whatever reason. Smoke in the air, binge drink. They lose it when the DJ drops the knee.
She's a good teaser. And we blowing your body like a work of art, baby. Don't fuck with me, I'll break your heart, baby.
I'll break your heart, baby.
D&G on me, I got a lot of flip. 1500 on my feet, I'm trying to kill these haters. When I was broke, I'm rich, I still got haters. I ain't when I was broke, I'm rich, I'm still a player. I wear leather Gucci jackets like it's still the 80s. I've been blowing OG, I feel elucidated. I can't worry about a broke or a hater. Black Beetle, me and Palmer gun related.
That girl is a real crowd.
All right, we are back live on Real Fans, Real Talk. Ladybug is in the building. We got a separate seat for her since Mace was being a little creepy.
Holy
shit. See? I'm just joking. I got to say this too
because I told y'all know the rappers like to be late. Math just walked in the building. You know, shout out to Math. You know, and I know why he did. See, he just going to walk on live television.
No, oh my gosh.
This is what happens, you know.
We got a mic for you over there, might as well.
Since then I just walked out, you might as well just have a seat now. Hold on, Ladybug, can we switch? Because Math come out.
When the artist comes, you gotta abide by the artist.
This is what, he thinks it's the URL stage. He could just come up here and just do what he want to do. Y'all better get him some chicken or something, because you know how he get. He probably didn't eat this morning or something. Are he good? All right, so we're not going to have no incidents then today.
We got a mic for you right here. You got a seat right here. Your own chair.
I know what happened.
Math wanted to make sure he got an extra day coming on. Let's get Math a mic.
Please get him a mic. This is what he do. All right.
That way you can stretch your legs
out. Exactly.
Couple of big boys on this table here.
Just adjust.
See, this is exactly.
It's gonna take.
Listen. Listen. Hey, come. He coming to man cave. Putting his feet up. Oh my goodness. He knocking stuff down. All right. So he got a battle, you know, in London. So now he come over. He just come acting up in the studio,
just
but we gonna
it.
Let it go because that's how Brooklyn do. So we just gonna let it rock for right now. We definitely appreciate Math coming through.
Know how I know y'all foul? Why y'all got boxing gloves on the table, son?
Because first of all, let me tell y'all this: that man fought in the Golden Gloves. Everybody at home knows that. Now, Math, you did volunteer to be his sparring partner.
I've been retired for a little bit.
So them your chip gloves?
Exactly.
I mean, those were gloves since I was a kid, but we got those autographed by different boxes.
Since you was a kid?
Listen,
yeah.
Your hands that big?
A teenager, excuse me.
I am done.
Yeah, there's a lot going on. First of all, man, shout out to Beth, man. We definitely appreciate you coming through. Yeah, we're gonna get as much as we can get in these last 11 minutes. This means you definitely gonna have to come back next, because we gotta get an hour with you. 10 minutes
if
is not
back,
enough
I'm coming
time.
Back with people, sir.
You always with somebody. It's all good. You bring them with you. We're gonna talk about it. We're gonna start with the battle, because you do got a battle coming up. You're going to London.
Shots the Rebel. November 18th.
Once again, now we spoke about this at the Barclays Center. I didn't know the guy then. I don't know him now. Who is this guy?
Wait. Hold on. Now you got to check. He just had I'm not even going to lie, he just had a classic with Tony D. And Tony D's the top dog out there now.
You know what I like? In these kind of moments, what I like to go to is that patented Young Ill line. He likes. I can't say the exact
Smack.
Line.
Who is
this?
Oh, you can't curse on this?
We can't curse on here. So I can't say the line.
So you don't bring me up on this. Come on, son. All right.
But you got, all right. So
good
you
thing
got,
I found out.
You got Shox the Rebel in London.
Yeah.
What's going on in that battle? How are we looking?
You know, Shox, he's an up and comer, but he's definitely making the most noise out there. There was a hierarchy. There was Shotty, then it was Tony. Now Shox is like the dude.
So he's the next up in London. Right. But, man, if you're going out there, Brooklyn on your shoulders, we're not even hearing less than 3-0.
Bro, you're not worried about this.
Oh, no, I'm not worried about that.
You can't even do that. I mean, when I land out there, chances are, like, most of the people in the building been watching me more than they've been watching him.
Yeah, that's facts. You know what I mean? I said, I never heard of him, and I'm a huge battle rap fan, and I've never even heard of this kid. So when you said
I beat Shotty with 2 rounds.
Then they... But that was just disrespectful what you did. You
hey
know.
Man, you know now, he cared. I didn't. You feel me?
That's now what? Okay, what is it about this? Because you know, if it's not on the URL, it doesn't count.
Nah. I don't believe in that. That's just more of just that was a tactic for him because he battled a couple other top tiers and they didn't even take him seriously. So his wins is like they don't count. Because people just show up and be like, it's a check. I'm in another country. I'm going to leave here. I'm going to go to the club. I'm going to go see London Bridge. I'm going to go see the Queen and all that. You know what I mean? So I know it felt, from the time that we booked it, it was like I could tell he's too hyped about this.
Yeah.
Watch this. Yeah. Skip. Go to the next round.
Well, all right.
You can see his face, too. He was like it happened again. Like, yeah. You know what I mean?
Somebody that will care, and is this a battle that we're gonna actually get?
Oh yeah, I'm not playing with Shox.
No. I'm talking Math versus Mook.
Is that gonna happen?
I know he's talking about this $100,000, but is that a battle that we can actually get?
If you get $100,000, I want $100,000 too. I want $150,000. Facts.
Do you feel like Mook is worth $100,000?
I mean, if he was, it would have happened already. You've been saying it for like 3-4 years now, right?
That is true.
But you know what? I see him doing his music thing, and I think that all battle rappers are in that graduating phase. The ones that made this hot, we in that graduating phase. So he's working on music. I'm working on music. You see DNA, he's working on music. K-Shine's working on music. A-Verb got a single out there called Showdown. It's fire. So I feel like we all getting to that point. Now, the dangerous thing about us is once we break through to mainstream, nobody better not say nothing to none of us. Because if you think Drake back-to-back and what he did to Meek Mill was crazy, imagine messing with one of us at that level. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it'll be ugly.
It's going to be ugly. It's going to be Madison Square Garden. Like, somebody just getting roasted.
Who do you think, outside of yourself, has the most potential to make that crossover? As you know, from battle rapper to
I can't say because everybody got a different sound to them, and what I don't like, somebody else might like.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Is what it is. No love. Peep that, right?
Now I'm gonna go while we on the live show. I'm gonna go in because you are doing the acting as well. You went from Respect Life to the Brooklyn Way, but something that a lot of people don't know, and this is what I'm gonna let y'all know. That when you really follow somebody's career and you're a fan, you know these things. But we're gonna go all the way back.
To talk about.
Now, Math was actually in the feature length film.
Feature feature length film
called Rap War One, which a friend of mine was, you know, one of the producers on.
I had two sex scenes in it. And two.
But I wasn't gonna go that far. I didn't even talk about all that. But that was, I think that was probably the first time that I actually saw meth. And then I saw you
getting
it.
Right now. You'll be like,
let me see.
Oh,
I'm
done. Tell us about that. And how come more people haven't spoken about that? Why do you think? And like in the battles.
Because it goes against your strategy. You know what I'm saying? If you bring that up, then you can't paint me as such an ignorant bully.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Because then you'd be like, wait, this ignorant bully, like, he was on Stars?
Yeah.
He submitted a film to the ABFF, and they picked it up. It got sold to Maverick, and then they licensed it to Stars. They ran it for 3 years?
Yeah.
It's not going to blend. You know what I mean? They'd rather go with the other. Is what it is.
And then now... Respect Life, you on that?
Respect Life.
And then the Brooklyn
I was on the
one.
First season.
Mm-hmm.
They pretty much blew up the first season. Yeah. Crazy, crazy. Now, I think they're like they're in the top five now, as far as like web series and all that. The Brooklyn Way, we up there now.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Red Man is in the joint. A whole host of Brooklyn rappers on the come up is in it.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to my man Gap Murder.
Definitely, you know, I mean? You know that's a friend of the show. Shout out to Gat. Yeah. You know, we're gonna get them guys back on the set as well, probably early next year once the first season wraps up. So shout out to everybody on the Brooklyn Way because they came through and chopped it up with us. What's the difference though? In as far as when you're doing the acting and the battle rap, which one is there more of a passion for one or the other?
Nah, you know, I'll be honest with you, it's like I like being creative. Period. I like performing. Mm-hmm. I'm like that. Everything, you know what I mean? Like down to when I'm alone with a chick, I'm performing. You know what I mean? I got routines. I got songs that I play. You know what I mean? A stroke for this song, stroke for that song. Like that's the type of. I just like performing. I like performing. So the acting thing, it allows me because most of the scenes that we do on the Brooklyn Way, as far as my scenes, they improv.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're watching it, like we working it out, like,
yeah,
right there. And if it works, then we keep it. If it don't, then we try it again. Come up with some other stuff.
Cause you had this sandwich scene.
Yeah.
With your cousin.
Now think about that. That was improv.
And when I see this is why, because when I see this kind of stuff, I immediately think back to did you saying that you know he was hungry at the cereal.
Now you know whose mind it came out of. You feel what I'm saying?
So that's a good thing. Really, really quick, Math, because we're running low on time. Just tell everybody at home, and we're gonna actually kick it with Math after the show goes off the air. So we're gonna have more for y'all with Math, but just let them know where they can get you at.
On Instagram, follow me at Hoffaluyah, HOFFALUYAH. Do not follow at Math Hoffa on Instagram. That's somebody else. He got me, he got LeBron, he got KRS.
Your Twitter's Math Hoffa, right?
He just snagged, yeah, my Twitter's at Math Hoffa.
Up there for everybody.
And check me out on YouTube/ Math Hoffa. Check out the videos, check out the Brooklyn Way, episode 7 coming soon. Y'all go, yo, when you see, look, man, we got to, I can't even blow it up, son. Yeah. I can't even blow it up, but it's
cut off.
No, just check it out. Just check it out.
So, thank you for joining us on the live episode. Make sure you check out Real Fans, Real Talk in the future. We're gonna have some more with Math Hoffa, Conor McGregor at the Garden. He said he runs New York, so I'm rooting for him to lose now. You're not from New York. You don't run anything. And that being said, thank you all for joining us. We'll see you next time, everyone.
Good night.
Juice.
Real fans, realtalk.com. Where Arthur Thomas, Trip Young, and intern Tom. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend the CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. Real fans, realtalk.com. Got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Is Jeremy Lin hurt?
We'll log onto the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives, even tell a neighbor, tell him Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter, tuning in should be the only